the hired help's driving me to school. Wow.
I am not hired help. I am a policeman.
Cop. Big deal.
You really should learn some manners, you know, Bonnie. Or
you're what? Lock me out?
Why can't you just be nice?
Why can't you just cop out, Max?
You don't want to be late.
Yes, I do.
You know, this should be a new law in the books.
Against what?
Against people trying to impersonate human beings.
Am I really that bad?
You're worse.
Max! You missed a little bit.
This is not what a policeman's job is supposed to be about. I'm supposed to be out there catching crooks and criminals, you know?
Yes, not driving girls to school. I'm with you there. Max, why don't we go out into the real world?
Hey, no, you don't. You're going to go to school and you're going to go right now. First day of domestic bliss.
Yeah.
How do you want to spend it?
Just like the honeymoon.
Yes.
Just the two of us. Mm.
Oh, no.
What's wrong?
Max.
He'll be at work.
Oh, right. He's my best friend then.
What are you doing?
Crossing the threshold is traditional.
Well,
into our first home together.
Don't you think you should open the door first?
Bride does that.
Oh, traditional?
Yep.
Service.
This is lovely, thanks.
Well, it's better than being in the hospital, isn't it?
Bob, I don't think I can eat this.
Okay. Well, just put it aside. And you might like to pick at it later. Everything's okay. You're home now. I'm here. Can I get you anything else? How about some tea? Now, you just get yourself well again. That's all that's important. Don't think about anything else. Okay? Promise?
You should have kept an eye on her.
Oh, Sarge, if anyone else had done it, they'd be charged. But Bonnie defaces the police car and I'm the one in trouble.
What is it now?
I've got blisters everywhere.
That's your own fault, Max. No passing the buck.
It isn't right, Sarge. She's making fun of us.
She's making fun of you, Max.
Well, then I don't want anything more to do with her, okay?
You're objecting to an official assignment, Constable?
No, Sarge.
Good.
Well, enough, Sarge.
Right, Sam, you watch him.
Where you going, Sam?
Pick up a parolee, Leo Benjamin Hambly.
Leo Hambly? He's the boxer. He's a nice bloke.
He was convicted of assault, Max.
He was rescuing a dog that was being maltreated by its owner.
Yeah, and in saving the dog, he nearly killed the owner.
Well, he might have overreacted a bit, but his intentions were good.
You're lucky for the rest of us, Max. You're not the judge, eh? Anyway, you watch him, son. He's a big man. He could be dangerous.
Will do, sir.
Maybe you could do us a backup, Sergeant.
No!
I never get to do any police work anymore.
West side, please, Sergeant Sullivan.
Thank you.
Would have got your bandana, mate, but they didn't have any, so here you go. That's all right. I'll tear this up.
No, you won't. So, you had a great time.
Oh, it was paradise. And just the two of us.
Yeah, and all thanks to Max.
Where is Max?
Ah, he's on a special assignment.
Looking after a schoolgirl.
She's a VIP. She's quite a handful.
Just don't worry about it, okay?
I won't. Not till later, anyway.
No, we'll catch up with our friends later.
Yeah, right.
thanks for the t-shirts, guys.
Yeah, thanks.
We'd better get going then, hey?
All right.
Oh, are you going?
Yeah, we've got things to do, you know, people to see.
Well, when you gotta go, you gotta go, I guess.
Do you have one of these for Charlie?
Oh, yes, yes. Oh, midget size, see?
And an extra large one for Ellie.
Ah, oh, you wouldn't have heard.
What?
Ellie had a miscarriage.
Excuse me, madam, you called about a shoplifter?
Hi, Max.
Riley, I thought you'd be in school.
Sarge?
Didn't you drive her there this morning?
Listen, Sergeant.
Oh, what's the excuse this time?
Come on, Max, you can say it.
Well, I went down to the shop to pick up the shoplifter, Sergeant.
And?
I'm it.
What?
She's the shoplifter, Sarge. What do I do now?
Do what you have to do with any common criminal. Charge her.
You mean that, Sarge?
Oh, well, maybe Section 48.
Section 48?
You know Section 48, don't you, Max? The dreaded Section 48 we only use in special cases.
Oh, that's Section 48. Wow, I didn't think you wanted to go that far, Sarge.
Section 48?
You'll find out.
Charlie will love this.
Do you think Toni and CJ are going to be okay?
Jamie, they practically pushed us out of the door.
Yeah, but I'm worried about food and that. I don't think they had anything in the house.
I don't think they give a hoot about eating right now.
Yeah, right. Well, I do. What's for brekkie?
Well, I was going to make a special brunch for CJ and Toni.
Oh, and you didn't get to tell them.
So you got a lot of stuff?
Yes, I have.
Well, we can't let it go to waste, can we?
No way.
Oh, all right, let's cook.
You guys stay right where you are. Jamie's egg surprise and muffins coming right up.
What type of juice do you want? You can have pineapple, tomato or orange.
Yep.
All three.
Yeah, I saw a cockroach. I can't stand them.
It's only one.
Of all the things in the world, I can't stand them, Jamie.
Okay.
Don't worry about them. In some parts of the world, they eat them.
Yeah.
We're gonna get the fumigator, the exterminator. You've got to help me!
Please, go. Please, Bob. We can't just stop our lives. I've made the move home from the hospital. A few more days, I'll be back at work too. You okay?
You bet.
Hi.
Toni! Look at you. You look so... radiant. Marriage agrees with you.
That's great, Toni.
Oh, thanks, Bob.
Well, you gonna stick around for me?
Yeah, sure, I'll stay.
Okay, good to see you. Back soon.
Okay.
Bye.
Elly, I'm so sorry.
Draco.
for you, Benjamin Hambly.
I didn't do anything wrong.
It's okay, relax, Leo. I've just come to pick you up.
Ah.
You got a sweet tooth?
I paid for them, officer.
All right, I haven't said you didn't. You got here a bit early. You ready? I'm Sam Farrell.
I'm Leo Benjamin Hambly.
Yeah, I know. That's quite a good grip you've got there, Leo.
Sorry.
You weren't, otherwise I would have spoiled your honeymoon.
Oh, Elly, why did it have to happen to you?
Oh, maybe it was for the best. Maybe it was fated to be this way. There might have been something wrong with the fetus. At my age, women often miscarry, fact of life.
So, are you going to try again?
I couldn't go through this again.
How did Bob take it?
Devastated. He was hoping so much to have a family again. But he's been really good to me. I think he's come to terms with it. He has to. Anyway, that's all in the past. What about the future, hmm? I might enjoy being a grandmother in the not-too-distant future.
Elly, we just got married.
You only have yourself to blame, Bonnie.
Oh, yeah? And you had nothing to do with it?
I didn't.
You forced me to go to school today, and I showed you, didn't I?
You went shoplifting to get back at me?
Leo Benjamin Hambly, eh? Wasn't he the heavyweight champ?
Yep, and he's got more than this one assault on his record. When he loses it, he's a hard boy to stop.
Well, how'd he handle prison?
Oh, one or two more KOs. Oh, looks like your new charges here, Bob. Yep.
Sergeant Sullivan, Reverend Brown, meet Leo Benjamin Hambly.
Pleased to meet you. Do you blokes too much fishing?
The Reverend Brown here, he's going to be your new parole officer. And from now on, you report to him. Now, I'm warning you, Leo, if you don't do what he says, I'm going to be right on your tail. And he's a much nicer man than I am. Understand?
Leo, I'm Bob.
How you going, Bob?
Thanks, George. I'll take over from here.
Good luck.
Now, Leo, I have to explain a few things to you. Before I start, have you got any questions?
You do much fishing?
What?
You ever catch a barramundi?
No, I can't say I have.
Pity. They reckon you can catch them this big up in Queensland.
Hey, did you see that? Cockroach just ran across the table.
What a loser you are.
Well, the cockroach put me off.
Oh, yeah, right. Hey.
Come on, I mean, you know, the plagues reach Patches, that's for sure.
Oh, my baby.
Oh. What's wrong?
Oh. Big, slimy cockroach.
Now, shut up, Jojo. You want to roll me? Where? Where?
You're seeing things. Stop sampling the stock.
Oh, it was here.
Yeah, and they cost me $5. Oh.
Now, parole is conditional, Leo. That means if you don't obey the rules, you'll have to go back inside.
Don't want to do that.
We have to get you a job, and you're not to consort with anyone with a criminal record. You got that? It says here that you spent a lot of time in solitary for getting into fights with other inmates.
So they were mean. They kept picking on me. Reckon I was a big joke.
And you just let fly.
Well, they all show some respect. I used to be a champ.
Well, you know what happens if you thump anyone again.
I don't want to go back inside, Bob.
Well, that's entirely up to you, Leo. You're the one that's got to go to work and pay the bills, and you've got to keep in touch. You think you can do that?
I'll try.
Good. If things get too hard or confused, you come to me first, and we'll try and work through this together, okay?
Where do we start?
Well, first of all, we got to find you somewhere to live. Now, I know a couple of places with reasonable rates.
They're near the water?
Yeah, not too far.
Good. I like fishing.
You ever been up Queensland way?
Yeah, but I don't think you've been doing too much fishing, Leo. We've got to get you a job.
No, I don't need no job.
No, why not?
I'm going to work with a mate.
Oh, a mate?
Yeah, he's got his own business, doing real good.
And what's his name?
Jack Brown.
Is infested.
Bulldust! I run a clean ship. You gotta eat off the floors in Patchit Pacific.
Yeah, if you like eating bugs.
Keep your voice down.
Ernie, listen, mate, have you got a room to rent?
For you, anytime.
Yeah, well, there's Penny and Charlie and Tess too. Just one night.
Sorry, mate. No can do. I can't have a dog in the house.
License.
Yeah, right.
Well,
don't worry. I'll find somewhere else.
Do you mind me asking you why you're looking for a room?
Oh, we're having our place fumigated. Come on, Penny. Cockroaches.
Oh, don't say that too loud.
Ernie. G'day, Bob.
Like to meet a mate of mine. Leo Hambly.
Pleased to meet you.
I saw you fight once.
Yeah? Did I win?
Sure did. Flattened the bloke in three. Early night all round.
I was good back then. I was good, Bob.
I know. Listen, Ernie, we're a bit stuck. Leo's been away for a while. We're having trouble finding accommodation. He needs a room just for the night. Till he finds somewhere more permanent.
I know. Certainly. Our finest budget suite available.
Right, good on you. Okay, I better get going. Ernie will look after you, Leo. I'll call back later and see how you're settling in.
Okay, thanks, Bob.
Keep an eye on him, you know.
Yeah. Hey, pop into the bistro and grab yourself a feed, mate.
I actually don't.
On the house. I want to pack it on you, champ.
Leah.
G'day, mate. I told you I'd find you, but not this quick.
Hey, why don't we just shake hands, mate? So when did you get out?
Yesterday. I caught the bus.
It's good to see you.
But this is so great. Now we can go fishing up in Queensland, eh, Jack?
You all right? Bonnie?
I was far away, in peace, until you had to interrupt.
Yeah? I brought you some lunch.
Did you get me some mung beans or sprouts or watercress?
Excuse me?
What have you got?
Hamburger with a lot.
How can you eat that?
Well, I'm not going to. I've had mine. This is yours.
A cow had to be killed so you could have lunch. How does that make you feel, Max?
Just awful.
So it should.
Your turn.
I want a salad.
Sorry, that's it. Take it or leave it. Regulations. You're in prison now. See you in prison chow.
Prisoner objecting to section 48, Constable.
Yes, Sarge.
Oh, I thought you smelled nice and sexy.
How's Elly?
Good, considering what's happened to her. But she said something nice, though.
Yeah?
She said how much she'd like grandkids.
Yeah. You can't let her down, then.
Ship, Captain.
They're all dead.
They probably died from their own filth.
Rubbish. Where'd you find them?
In the cellar.
They could have been there since before the war.
The place is swarming with them.
It'll take more than these fossils to convince me.
Well, I'm abandoning ship now. Oh,
Jojo.
Think about how much beer they can drink during the night.
Thank you.
Jack.
Oh, that. More trouble than they're worth.
You got a job for me?
Hey, I'll help you out.
Thanks, mate. I knew you'd look after me. Just like inside.
Just like inside.
Remember when we shared the cell? You used to talk to me.
And shut you up.
When we go on fishing.
Soon.
You said you'd show me how to catch a barramundi up in Queensland.
That's right, in Queensland. Got a good memory, mate.
We're gonna be mates forever, aren't we?
Yep, mates forever.
Oh, feels like we haven't done that in ages.
Oh. I was having withdrawal symptoms. And we got here this morning and all those guys rocked up.
What? You didn't like them coming over?
Did you?
Oh, they mean well.
Yeah?
And they are our friends.
So, who needs enemies, right?
Hang on.
Do you mind if we stay the night?
One night, that's all.
Can I ask you what? Our place is being fumigated.
Of course you can.
Thanks. Thanks, CJ. Cockroaches everywhere.
Yeah, right, they're worse than human beings.
Why haven't you been hit by the marauding hordes?
Max had our place bombed while we were away.
Look, do you mind if I just dump this stuff anywhere?
Don't mind us.
Yeah, sure.
Good.
This is for Tess, so she doesn't destroy any of your stuff.
Oh, right. Can we help you with anything?
No, that's about it. A couple more loads and then I can set up.
Set up?
Do you mind if I move some of the furniture? It would make it easier.
Sure.
Hey, listen, mate, I've got a heap of paperwork to finish tonight. Do you mind if I use the table?
Sure. I never go anywhere without Mom.
Hi, Toni. Hi, CJ.
Oh. Hi, Charlie. The rabbit. It's her favourite. She never gets anywhere without it.
There you are. That'll be $5.20. Here.
I gave you a 20.
Did you? I thought it was 10.
Nah, it was a 20.
Pretty sure it was $10 you gave me, but you say it was a 20, champ. It was a 20.
I gave you a 20 and I want my change.
Okay, okay. What was that all about?
I got him a good one, didn't I?
Give the money back, Leo.
Jack?
We don't do that sort of stuff anymore. Ernie's a mate. Give it back.
Jack, I've got to help out. I'm a good operator.
I'm not going to tell you again.
I was going to give it back. I was only testing.
No, that's fine. If you've settled with the managers at the shop, that's all that matters as far as we're concerned. Right, bye. Max, let the prisoner out.
Let her out?
Yeah, that was her father on the phone. He's spoken to the owner of the shop. She's decided not to press charges.
So we can't keep her anymore?
Not unless you can think of something else.
No, Sarge, the sooner she's gone, the better.
Well, let's just hope that she's learned her lesson.
I'm sure she has.
What makes you say that?
Well, a girl of her age having to spend the day in a police lockup. Pretty scary stuff.
Even it was only the old Section 48, eh, Max?
That was a beauty, Sarge. She actually thought that she was going to be charged.
Well, let's just hope we've scared some sense into her. See you in the morning, Max.
See you, Sarge.
What are you doing?
My homework. I'm being a good little girl.
You're defacing government property. I could charge you for that.
Well, what's another charge for a crim like me?
All right. Don't worry, I'll let you off this time.
Who's worried?
You're free to go.
What?
You're free to go.
Why?
Your father's gone and fixed it.
I don't want my father to fix it, and I'm not going.
Gotta go straight now, Leo.
But we're gonna be a team again.
Not if you do cheap con tricks. If you're caught by someone who doesn't know, you're back inside with no one to look after you. You understand me? Hey, I'm serious.
I'm sorry, Jack. I didn't mean to do it. Sorry. You won't send me back again, will you?
It's all right, man. Here, keep it. It's a present.
Thanks, Jack.
You asleep? No.
These are for you. Mrs. Marshall left them.
Oh, how sweet of her.
Yeah, everyone's been asking about you. You're sorely missed.
Good.
Well, how are you feeling?
I'm fine now. I just want to forget it ever happened and get back to work again.
Well, not for a couple of days. You've got a locum coming in.
Oh, I don't need that. I'm ready to start now.
No, you're not. Now, just relax.
The more time I spend on my own, the more I keep thinking back to it. I just want to get back to work and think about someone else's problems.
Well, you'll do that soon enough. Now, is there anything I can do for you before I go?
No. I could do with a bit of company.
Oh, sure.
Leo, I've told you, your parole forbids you from associating with other known criminals. What do you think you're doing, Jack?
Having a drink with a mate.
Yeah, yeah, the sort of drink that's going to get him back inside.
Oh, I was doing nothing wrong. Jack's just looking out for me.
No, that's my job.
We're going to work together.
No, you're not.
But we're mates. Tell him, Jack.
Come here. Why don't you just lay off and he's done nothing wrong?
But how long's that going to last with you, Mel?
Listen, he's just like a little kid. Half the time he thinks everything's a game. And he's protection.
Oh, yeah? What, and you're going to charge him a fee? Come on, Jack, I'm not some novice off a social work course. You're no good for him and you know it.
Fine, Rev. You want to save his soul? You take care of him. Okay?
Jack, come back!
Leo, let him go. Let him go. He's no good for you.
But he's my mate, Bob.
Well, you're better off without mates like him. Really, you got to listen to me. Stay right away from him. Come on.
Me and Jack are going to go fishing.
You can't, Leo, till you've served your parole.
You gave me this.
Listen, what's it to be? Flash toys or a chance to try and make a new life on the outside? Look, it's not going to be easy out here. And if it was, then there'd be something wrong with it.
Nah, Jack wouldn't hurt me.
Leo, stay right away from him.
Jack and me look out for each other. There's nothing wrong with that.
Bonnie, I'm telling you, you can go.
I don't want to. It's not fair, Max. I shouldn't be allowed to. I committed two crimes.
I am the law and I'm saying you can go.
Just because my father said so.
It's not because of your father.
Oh, yes, it is. Just because he's a VIP politician. He can pick up the phone and get anybody off. And in this case, it just happens to be his daughter.
The manageress of the shop has not pressed any charges. Therefore, there are no charges against you. Therefore, you are free to go. It doesn't have anything to do with your father.
The manageress didn't press any charges, Max, because there was nothing to charge me with. I didn't shoplift. She's a friend of mine. I set the whole thing up so that you would get into trouble for not looking after me. I did it so you'd get off my case.
You didn't shoplift?
No.
Why do you persist in giving me a hard time?
Could say the same about you.
You coming?
In a minute, I'll just get my bag.
What are you doing?
What's for dinner, Constable?
Give me.
Maybe over here. It'll give us more room.
You make up your mind. I can't keep doing this all night.
Why not? I've got nothing better to do.
Will this be enough? Oh, yeah, plenty. You should keep some for yourself.
Oh, I've got CJ to keep me warm.
Oh, you poor thing. This is your first night back and we barge in here and squeeze you into a corner. How insensitive, how rude. How typically male. Jamie, you comfortable?
It's all right, honestly.
No, it isn't.
What's wrong?
Nothing, everything's fine.
We'll organize the beds and then lights out and you and CJ can retire to your room and do whatever it is that married people do, whatever that may be.
Thanks, Penny. And if I hear a peep out of anyone, I'll fumigate you. Do you want to help me with
this? Hi, Tony. Do you think you could put us up to the night?
Yeah, our place has been overrun by cockroaches.
Yeah, we just went I know.
Fumigator come true. Said
it. Cool.
Hey, guys, what are you doing here?
I don't go.
Cockroaches. What are you doing here?
Cockroaches.
Fine, then I can't sleep.
All right. Night. Can you explain something to me, Bonnie?
Sure.
Why do you give me such a hard time? What have I actually done to you?
Max, tell me something. Have you ever heard of the golden toad?
The golden what?
Toad.
Sort of.
How many of them are there in the world today?
Don't know. A million?
So sad. You just like the rest.
Eh?
Max, the golden toad lives in the high mountains of Peru. Every year it waits for the summer mist to form puddles in the jungle.
Puddles?
The puddles are the only way it can breed. Without them, it dies. The puddles are formed by mist from condensation off the trees. No trees, no mist. No mist, no puddles. No puddles, no golden toads. Do you get it?
I'm trying.
Max, do you know that we destroy a hectare of rainforest every second of every day and that there are only 500 golden toads in the whole world left?
That's terrible.
Of course it's terrible.
Well, if that's why you give me a hard time, if I could help the golden toads, I would help the golden toads, I'm telling you.
So would I. But I can't, because I don't have any power. But on the other hand, my father has lots of power. And what does he do with it? Spends his time hobnobbing with other politicians.
And they could help the golden toad.
Right. But they won't. They don't give a damn about the things that are really important, Max. Like the survival of this planet. Just between you and me, I reckon that my father is the worst out of the whole lot of them.
Well, Bonnie, I don't think you're going to change his mind by getting yourself arrested.
Maybe I won't. But at least this way I get his attention. No, Max.
All right, Bonnie.
Jack? Jack? Oh, wait for me. Where are we going?
I don't know where you're going, but you're not coming with me.
Jack, we're mates.
Yeah, that's why you're not coming with me.
Our mates go together. Listen.
You heard the red. I'm trouble.
Jack?
We've been inside together. You're on parole. We can't be seen together. You've got to stay away from it.
Then you're going to leave me on my own?
If I don't, you go back to prison, you understand? We've got no choice, mate. You gotta stay away from me.
G'day, Bob. And
George, the usual.
Hey, give me some of that fire water the Reverend's enjoying. You okay?
Yeah.
Terrific. Come on, Bob. What is it?
You know, George, sometimes I get really sick of playing the righteous reverend.
Righteous? It's strong, isn't it?
I just had to come the heavy with Leo Hambly. It's like talking to a small child. You almost burst into tears.
Leo Hambly, not in trouble already.
No. He's just hanging around. Jack, I had to warn him off, that's all.
You know the law, Bob. If I catch them consorting, I'll be down on them so hard they won't know what hit them.
I know, and they'll go back inside, the citizens will feel safe, and the world will be a better place, right?
In your brother's case, Dipper.
And what about Leo? Is he on the most wanted list now, too?
Jack. Hey, Jack. Whoa, wait a minute, hang on. Jack, come here. Relax, Leo's not hiding in here, okay?
Listen, that was nothing personal, Jack, really. You know what the law says. Come on, sit down.
Yeah, I know what the law says. Reverend Brown, you want to be the big man, the big-time parole officer, fine. Just don't make me watch. It makes my skin crawl.
Hey, look, you just don't get it, do you?
Don't I? Where else are you going to go? Who else is going to look after him? What if he came straight here to Westside in the first place when he got out? Because he's got one mate in the world, and that's me.
But he's going to have to find another mate who hasn't been inside. He's going to have to learn to fend for himself.
Leo Hambly's got more heart and more love in his guts than you'll ever know. just simple, like a puppy. He gets kicked, he snaps back, he can't help it. The more you kick him, the more he snaps. And he's gonna get kicked a lot out there by himself. Isn't he, Mr. Parole Officer?
Jack, hang on, look.
Demand, I shall sing my latest composition.
Do you have to?
Oh, I thought that was overwhelming demand.
Yeah? Well, I am trying to work here.
Oh, Jamie.
No, fair's fair. You guys have been singing for quite a while.
Fair? That computer's interfering with my amp.
So, what's that got to do with it?
Well, you wouldn't be complaining if it was a string quartet.
No, that's because it'd be real music.
Oh, and so what I sing isn't.
Jojo, I don't think Jamie actually meant that.
Well, actually, I...
Well, try and concentrate with this. Couldn't put us up for the night, could you?
Why not? I mean, Reg, join the party.
So much for our romantic evening.
I don't know about that. Well, at least we've got the bedroom to ourselves.
And more important, the bed.
Did you hear that?
Doesn't matter.
Hear us downstairs.
Not above the noise there.
Jim Ben.
Thanks, mate. Attention, everybody. Shh, please. Excuse me. Today is their first night home, and I think we should be reasonably quiet.
Yeah. Too right. We are guests, after all.
Awfully quiet downstairs.
Don't worry. You're going to sleep.
There's a lot more comfortable places than this place, you know.
I'm not interested in being comfortable.
You've made your point. You've got your father's attention. You can go now.
I don't want to go. I've got nowhere to go to.
Bonnie, if you stay here the night, Sarge is going to kill me. I could even lose my job.
Then I'd be doing you a favor and the rest of the world. There'd be one less bully around.
I'm not a bully.
Maybe you're not, Max, but what you're doing is pushing people around, upholding the establishment.
And protecting people. Helping people that can't help themselves. I didn't join the force to push people around.
Why didn't you become a doctor or a barrister then?
Because I became a policeman. And I'm proud of it.
You haven't answered the question, Max.
I wasn't very good at school. Not as good as you could be.
Didn't study, huh?
Never had time to study. Brothers and dad always getting in each other's way. Family sort of fell apart. Never really had time to think about an education. Brothers went wild. Couldn't really blame them. Never really had a stable family to go to, did they?
Didn't you try and look after them?
They were always older and bigger than I was. Like Dad. Fighters and drinkers. Always getting into trouble. Always breaking the law. Never caring for whose lives they ran over.
The world is all so wrong.
It all worked out for the best. So do you want to go home now? I'll leave you alone. Is there anything I can get you?
I want the forest to be untouched. And I want the planet to be saved.
Sounds good to me. Night, Bonnie.
Max. You're not bad for a cop. Don't worry. I won't tell anybody.
Catch up on the very latest triumphs and tragedies at Falcon Crest next here on Sky One. And then at two, the Harts take charge of a dog who happens to be carrying a valuable biogenetic formula in Heart to Heart.